500 at some of the best, most prestigious athletic and academic institutions, and I found that few, if any. As a matter of fact, I went to get the data from people who counseled athletes on a day-to-day basis as a part of their job. They indicate that none of the students in my study would graduate. Well, we found that some did graduate. The way they graduated was to be in school 12 months a year.
John Thompson's been fairly cool. You will notice Georgetown players do not talk to officials. John Thompson says, hey guys, that's my job. You guys play ball, go to school, and graduate. A high percentage of these kids graduate from Georgetown, and that's a very important statistic in the mind of John Thompson.
If results are the true test of effectiveness, then you have to admit that Coach Thompson's method works. Of a total of 37 players that he's coached, significantly, 35 have graduated.
I think that athletes, particularly blacks, have to get away from the mentality that somebody's going to come and save them and take care of them and look after them. That the large part of that responsibility has to be that they have got to prepare themselves also for their educational responsibilities as well as to prepare themselves athletically.
An alarming number of young black people who are recruited to play football and basketball at white colleges never graduate. Many college athletic programs now look more like professional sports than extracurricular activities, and black players dominate the most successful teams. Does all of this mean that they're being exploited, or are they willing collaborators gambling with their lives? I'm Tony Brown. In a moment, the Sports Plantation.